Different order? Keep it a little definition there, though. Virginia Soil and Water Conservation Districts. Soil and Water Conservation Districts, we actually have 47 Soil and Water Conservation Districts in the state of Virginia. We have Soil and Water Conservation Districts in every state in the United States. And we each cover different areas. You probably can't see that map very well. My district covers the cities of Virginia Beach and Chesapeake. Soil and Water Conservation Districts were developed during the Dust Bowl. And we primarily work with our agriculture producers. And that is the reason why in this area we only have Soil and Water Conservation Districts in the city of Chesapeake and Virginia Beach, because that's the only place we have agriculture in this area. Years ago, when we went back and looked at the records for Virginia Dare, I think we were established in maybe 1946. But in that time, there weren't any agriculture areas other than what was called Norfolk County back then. So that's how we were established. So in each area in Virginia, you're going to have different soil and water conservation districts. The district that covers Suffolk, Surrey, and Iolite, their name is Peanut Soil and Water Conservation District. So you get that? Peanut Soil and Water? So why do you think we're called Virginia Dare Soil and Water Conservation District? Anybody know? Anybody? Take a guess?
It used to include Dare County.
So, no. We're actually named after the little girl, Virginia Dare, first child born on American soil. And I know that because once I started working there, I had to go and find the history in our records and our minutes, because I kept saying, what? I was like, it was Dare County, but we're not in North Carolina. So, but that's the reason why we were called Virginia Dare Soil and Water Conservation Districts. Soil and Water Conservation Districts were actually a subdivision of the state of Virginia. And we have elected directors. We have two elected directors from Virginia Beach, two elected directors from Chesapeake, one appointed, and one cooperative extension agents. And we're under the Department of Conservation and Recreation. They are our partner agency. We're actually under that agency. Our federal partners are the United States Department of Agriculture, and we're actually housed with them. And our primary job at the Virginia Dare Soil and Water Conservation District is to implement Virginia's agriculture cost share program, or best management practice. We actually pay our producers in the cities of Virginia Beach and Chesapeake to put conservation practices on the ground. This year, we will pay out actually over $800,000 in cost share assistance. 75% of the cost of any conservation practice that is approved by the state of Virginia to protect our natural resources. The largest conservation practice in the cities of Chesapeake and Virginia Beach is called cover crop. So anybody familiar with cover crop? Cover crop? Probably not dealing with that because that's agriculture. But it's actually when our producers, they don't have any crops down on the land, we actually pay them to plant temporary grasses. And that will help conserve some of the soil erosion that we have going on in Chesapeake and Virginia Beach. We have a huge problem with soil erosion going on in the cities of Chesapeake and Virginia Beach. So that's, I think this is just a filter strip on some land. I don't even think that's here, that's in the mountains. So, but that is the primary job of soil and water conservation districts. In the city of Virginia Beach and Chesapeake, we're a little different. We are losing a lot of agriculture there, as you probably know. In the other parts of the state of Virginia, they have more agriculture. So once we started looking at our programs and our agriculture programs, so we're losing a lot of ag land. So what are we going to do to be relevant as a soil and water conservation district? So that's when we developed our educational program. Okay, so that's when my lovely board of directors hired me 20 years ago, and we started our educational programs. So So some of Virginia Dare's educational programs, we have programs where we present environmental education in the classroom in both the cities of Chesapeake and Virginia Beach, public schools, private schools, we have preschool presentations that we do. We actually have an extensive at-risk preschool program. We have teacher workshops annually, and we work with our USDA partners on our backyard conservation program. And so now we're just going to take a look at some of our educational programs, putting conservation on the ground, and we actually put a little A in that STEM because we do have BARCs, the poster contest that we do at Soil and Water Conservation Districts. Our largest program that we do is our annual farm days. We have 1,600 students that we host for 4 days of farm days, first graders. And they all learn about agriculture and environmental education. This is our 20th year. These students are able to feel, touch, and see where their food comes from. These students are actually making grain art. Our three largest crops that are grown in our district are corn, soybean, and wheat. So we have corn, soybean, and wheat, and all of our students that come out, they're actually in a honey jar, a little plastic jar, and they make grain art. So they can fill it, they actually put it in the jars, and they can take it home. And many times, these students have never actually seen any kind of agriculture product, you know, outside of the store. This is one of our stations. We have Imagination Garden at our farm days, because students learn through play. That's one of my passions that I'll talk about a little later. But this is just an imagination garden because we actually have snacks for the students. And that is some ground up cookies, which is sort of soil. And we have little gummy worms that they can put in there so they can see how the soil is tilled by earthworms. We actually have livestock. We do our Virginia Beach farm days at Hunt Club Farm, they're one of our partners. So that's out at Hunt Club, and you can see they're actually touching some of the chickens and some goats we have out there. We actually bring in our pumpkins from our local farmers, and all students will go and run out there and take a pumpkin. They're able to take it home. They have wagon rides where they're going all around the farm, and they can actually get a pumpkin. And farm-based educational resource packets, we're actually in the process of taking applications for our farm days right now. We can only take 800 students from Virginia Beach and 800 from Chesapeake. But as an extension outreach to our farm days, all of the students will receive resources, and the teachers will actually receive material in the classroom. And as you can see on that back table, I took up a lot of room, and I have material for any teachers that would like to take some of the educational materials that I have there. But these are some soybean crayons that we have. And why do we give out soybean crayons? Because we promote agriculture. And our growers are growing soybeans. So we want our students to understand that, you know, having soybeans is something that we can actually make products from. So that's our soybean crayons. Department of Forestry, they actually gave us some rulers. And I think the school to soil is actually over there too. That's some of our partners, our Virginia Beach Master Gardeners. We actually have a small staff at the Virginia Air Soil and Water Conservation District. So when we put on an event such as our farm days, we actually have to use our community partners and some of our conservation partners, some of the Virginia Beach Master Gardeners. We have beekeepers out there. Southeast Dairy Association, they come out. Other soil and water conservation districts, Virginia Department of Conservation and Recreation, and the Hampton Roads Planning District Commission, and Department of Forestry, Agriculture, just too many people to name. We usually have about between 65 and 70 volunteers that come out and help us with this farm days. Some of the classroom programs that are offered, I actually go into the classrooms in the schools, and I present some environmental education. The Envirosphere. That is the main tool that I use when I go and I speak to students. So I can actually show them what happens in their watershed when pollution is put down. And they can actually look, hardscape model. In the second half, I talked to them about some urban and actual agriculture best management practices. And I say we like to call it SWAPA. Does anybody know what SWAPA stands for? Anybody can guess? Natural resources. Now I feel like I'm in the classroom. Natural resources SWAPA. What would be the first thing? Soil,
water,
air, plants, and animals. Those are the five major living natural resources that we are trying to conserve in the cities of Chesapeake and Virginia Beach. And when I'm finished in the classroom, the kids are yelling, SWAPA, and I tell them right behind my desk, I have two offices in Virginia Beach and Chesapeake, is SWAPA that I can see every day when I come to work. So I know what my job is doing, trying to conserve some of these soil, water, air, plants, and animals. That's the actual environscape with me with some of the students. Sure, the environscape is actually in my car, so I could have brought it in here. But the children actually see the different types of pollution down. I use like a green Kool-Aid for fertilizer, a red Kool-Aid for pesticides. I use some brown sprinkles for Fluffy's poop. And so we actually put all these different types of pollution, soy sauce for oil, we put it down in the ground, and we make it rain, and they can actually see what's going on. And usually the lesson for the SOL is the Chesapeake Bay. So that's usually the bottom part where you see the Chesapeake Bay. And I actually do STEM nights at some of the elementary schools. If I have time, I'll go out. That's our classroom program, SWAPA. They used to call me the pollution lady when I first started, because I would come in with all of this bag of trash and I would throw it on the table, and I would have the students kind of go through it and see how to recycle. So that's some of the things. Some of our high school opportunities, because some of the classroom programs, most of my programs, I'm working in elementary and with the middle school, but we also have opportunities for high school students. That is our Envirothon. Has anybody ever heard of the Envirothon? Well, that's where we have high school students in the grades from 9th to 12th grade, and they actually compete in different categories. And we have local competitions, then we have area competitions, and then they go to the state and actually to a national competition. We just finished up all of our Envirothons, and our students will be going to Virginia State to compete for the state level next weekend. And I have all this information on our website. We also have a youth conservation camp where we send students from Chesapeake, Virginia Beach, all over Virginia to go up to Virginia Tech for a whole week of conservation camp. This is hands-on. The students are actually outdoors, they're canoeing, they're hiking, they are taking water samples and actually getting their hands dirty. We have our scholarship that we offer to, sometimes we will open it to our college students. Right now we're just accepting applications from our high school students, and I have some applications back there as well. And that's for any student that is majoring in a curriculum of biology, any of the sciences with an emphasis on natural resources or conservation, even if they're going into education and they want to teach environmental education, they can apply for our scholarship. I think last year we gave out 5 scholarships. This is my favorite thing. This is our outreach education. We actually go out and work with our students at the Head Start and Early Discoveries. These are at-risk youth. And I put this here, appreciation. Students who are introduced to the environment and have the opportunity to see where their food comes from at an early age have a lifelong relationship and appreciation of their natural resources. I feel, that which we love and appreciate and want to conserve later on. So we feel if we introduce these students to environmental education at an early age, they will learn to appreciate. And this is a program that is near and dear to my heart because I actually went to my board probably about 8 times and asked them, let's do this outreach to at-risk students who they will normally not have environmental education, they don't know where their food comes from. So once I started going in the classroom, I asked the students, where do you think eggs come from? And the first thing I hear is Walmart. Wait a minute, before Walmart, where are they coming from? when I go to speak to the preschoolers. And I'm like, okay, okay, I could do this. This is a little chicken that was in the box. So when I got to the Head Start, I opened this thing up, and when I say this was a big chicken, it's running around the room. I'm running around the room. I'm screaming, what's going on? But anyway, those are some of the things that we do with these, with some of our students, so they can actually see what's going on. One of the things that Virginia Dare, a couple of years ago, we actually partnered with the Head Start organization, and I helped write a grant with them for $10,000, so every Virginia Beach Head Start would have an outdoor garden. That was very near and dear to my heart as well, because I wanted these students to be able to go outside and grow their food, see where their food is coming from, and they can have somewhere where they can go read stories, they can do all kinds of different things. So all of those raised bed gardens are at the centers in Virginia Beach. And actually, when we put in those raised bed gardens, we actually had a teacher workshop. I facilitated a project learning tree with them so they can actually have a curriculum for the students. This was an early education curriculum that I did with the Head Start teachers. We also do community outreach, which is kind of what I'm here doing today. And we actually go out to festivals. That's why I actually went crazy with all this material back here, because usually when we do go out and we do any type of outreach, I like to have a lot of material for people to take back and have in the classroom. We actually have a backyard conservation program where we're putting conservation on the ground 1 yard at a time, and we have some material back. That's me and Smokey the Bear out at some of our festivals. And that's just me talking to, I can't remember where I was at that time, but actually promoting our backyard conservation program. And as I said, we do teacher workshops. Usually when I do a teacher workshop, I'm a facilitator for Project Wet Water Education Training and Project Learning Tree. I do teacher workshops, not just for Chesapeake and Virginia Beach teachers, but I do it for the whole area, for the whole region. So we will usually post a teacher workshop in the newspaper, or you can find it on our website, and I try to do that twice a year. And we also partner with Agriculture in the Classroom, and we do those teacher workshops as well. And if any teachers are here and they want to have a workshop, I'll be glad to come out and help with that. This is one of our Project Learning Tree workshops I did with the Chesapeake Master Gardeners last year. We actually were in my office in the one thing, and then we went outside on a safari hunt, so I actually had them outside. Very hot that day. That's just some of our material. This is just a recap of some of our educational programs. And here's how you can find us on the web. We have a website, Virginia Dare, or VADARESWC.com. And you can find us on our Facebook page, and all of our information is there. And now, I just want to do the second half, kind of to give you a story about me and how I came into this wonderful world of conservation. And since all of water has a perfect memory and is forever trying to get back to where it was, Toni Morrison, one of my favorite authors. A little bit about me. I don't know if everybody can see that picture. The first one is a picture of New York City in the 1970s. That's where I'm from. That's where I was born. That's where I live. The other picture, does anybody know where that is? What it looks like? The mountains, Appalachian. So my family is from West Virginia as well. So a little bit about me. I always longed for what I had as a child. When I spent long winter and fall and spring in New York. And in the summers, I went to my grandmother's house in West Virginia. And that's where I had long summers where I could play outdoors, unstructured play, just outside learning, being with my environment, and all of that actually, I feel, got on the inside of me and did something to me. So my passion is to make sure that every child has the opportunity to spend as much time time as I did as a child or more outdoors? Because you have to ask yourself that question. Are your children spending as much time outdoors as you did? Literally, we were outside until my grandmother called us in to eat lunch. And then we didn't, I would say until street lights came on, but we didn't have any in West Virginia. So it's when it got dark, that's when you came in. So learning through play. Imagination play can lead you to anywhere you want to go. So my passion is, again, to make sure that students have the opportunity to actually learn through play. A little bit about me. I have my bachelor's degree from Mountain State University in Business Administration. Then I went back to school through the University of Wisconsin, Environmental Education. And these are just some of the other training opportunities that I was able to take advantage of, actually through my job. I have been working with Virginia Dare Soil and Water Conservation District for 20 years. And so I went to school, then I decided, okay, I'm going to get into this environmental education, and I asked my board if you want me to develop an educational program, will you pay for me to take college courses and go back to school, and they said yes. So that was like a yes, yes, yes. So sometimes you can take a role that is a little less traveled, and that is what I did. I did a career change after living overseas in Italy, came back, and I said, I do not ever want to be in charge of adults in my life again. Never, ever, ever. So I said, hold the bill, my blinkers on, and I actually changed careers midterm. So I just want everybody to understand that you're never too old to make a change, and you don't always have to go the traditional way where people have to go to school and go to school and go to school. And I'm not, and I hate to say that because I'm at a college, and there's nothing wrong with that. You really need that as a foundation. But I just want people to understand that, you know, there are different ways to do things. And challenges in our career, many. Solutions, I always say, follow your passion. You want to make sure that you are in a mentorship, whether somebody's mentoring you or you're mentoring that person. Hands-on experience, especially when you talk about conservation or agriculture, you want to have hands-on experience. You want to learn, listen, and love. As a district manager, I actually do all of the hiring for the district, and when I see resumes, and I may see a whole bunch of education, and I don't see any kind of hands-on experience, any internship, anything like that, we actually turn all of those people away because we want to make sure. And here's just some of the intern and scholarship opportunities that we have. And like she said, it'll be on the website, but through our scholars program, through the USDA, they actually have a pathways program as well once you graduate. With the United States Department of Agriculture, they have a program that you can get in where you can internship, you can have summer interns and all that. So you can check all of that out. And my time is up. All right, well, thank you.
Thank you, everyone.